Whoa! Just a friend here, not a threat. Just had some questions for you.
You came out of the vault, right?
I thought it was empty. Wait, is the door still open? Wait, so did you come out of that vault? We both presumed it was empty. The door's not still open, is it? Son of a bitch, we missed our chance. We really needed that.
We got a tip from the Wayward. Heard of the place? New bar down the road.
So this guy told us that...
After you gave him the last of our caps?
And he said that inside that vault is the, you know, that's where the big one is.
Our last chance to turn our lousy luck around.
You know, the thing that brought everyone back. The treasure. Well, yeah, there was this big broadcast, but shouldn't you... know what was in there?
I told you, Lacey. The guy was scamming us.
But those were the last of our caps. No. Someone has to know something. We're just gonna stick it out until we find them.
Wonderful.
Thanks for answering some questions for us, I suppose. Seems only fair I return the favor. Anything we can answer for you? Oh, now that you mention it, I guess I could spare these. Here. Watch yourself out there.
Thank you. Sunny makes a good hoagie.
You want a real drink?
Scorch of the ferals don't get you. The rats will.
I'll take another. Maybe just one more whiskey. What's that over there? Cheers, friend.
Thank you. Lady, I will paint the walls with you if you don't tell me where Crane's treasure is right now!
Sweetheart, honey, you picked the wrong time to get a drink.
What are you? Hey! Who the hell are you? Outnumbered, shit. Fine, but don't think this is the end.
Only for you, honey. No one pulls a gun on me in my bar. Mort, get out here.
Yeah, what, Duchess?
Jesus! You let one of those monsters in here?
Hey, you want to see if there's a tomorrow? Then I want you to tell me where you and the rest of your numbskull crew is hiding out. What the? Mort, what was that?
Called me a monster. All right, what? He was gonna kill us.
You know, we could have asked him some questions.
Oh. You know what? It's safer this way anyway.
I suppose. Now, I'm hoping you're here to have a drink and play nice. I've had a gun pointed at me more than enough for one day. Well, not exactly the introduction to the Wayward I would have hoped for. Well, sorry about that, darling. First round's on me. Name's Duchess. There's something I could do for you. Overseer, huh? So you must be the one. No, I haven't seen her, but I have heard her. My people found a tape she left behind for one of her dwellers at that camp across the way, though it is a bit out of date now. Maybe you're the one she left it for. I'm happy to hand it over. Though, now that we've drifted naturally onto the topic of helping one another, maybe there's something you could do for me in return. Just agreeing to lend us a hand in a little diplomatic intervention. See? That boy we put down? He's not the first of his crew to roll in here. But I want him to be the last. Normally, I'd send my people out to clean house. But my muscles run off, so I don't have the bodies to spare right now. But I'm willing to pay good money if you put an end to this for me. So, what do you say? $50 caps if you can get the job done. 75's as high as I'll go, and for that kind of money, I expect to never hear from those boys again. Now, that mean you're on the case? That's what I was hoping. So, the details. Now, each of these boys came in asking after Crane. I'm thinking we can make that work for us. How would you grab the attention of a bunch of single-minded thugs? Sure thing, Captain. We're gonna draw these boys in by making them think you're Crane. Just give me one second. Okay, I think I'll just... I just want you to know, architecture ain't exactly my forte. Not half bad. So what I have chicken scratched together here for you is the schematic for one custom-made Crane Treasure Hunting Inc. sign. If I didn't butcher the plans too bad, it's got a little system built in that'll make sending out an advertisement and getting this gang's attention a snap. You just need to build it, use the tape it spits out to tell the world you're open for business, and then convince any punks that show up to tell you where their boss is hiding. They did teach you all how to build from schematics up in that vault of yours, didn't they? That's the spirit.
Hey, if you need a refresher, good old Morty Mort can help you out.
What are you on about, Mordecai?
Hey, nah, I'm not bragging or anything. But I've got some tapes that cover that very subject.
Oh, Mort, not the tapes.
Well,
You find yourself wanting a refresher? Talk to Mort. Of course you're gonna need materials, but we should have enough lying around to cover you there. Get you together a little care package. Throw some rations in there too, so you don't starve on me. And so you know, you might have to break some of this scrap down for parts. But I can spot you some workbench materials too, since you're doing me such a big one. Who knows? Maybe you'll learn something while you do it. Now, you ready to get this show on the road? Hot dog. Be good to have those dolts off our back at long last. Just make sure, once you find out where they're hiding, that their leader gets the message. The Wayward gets left alone. And here, that overseer tape. Sounds like she set up that camp across the way so her people could get some practice in self-reliance. Probably worth looking into if you think you could use a refresher.
Glad to hear Vault-Tec actually took care of some of their people. You hear these rumors, right, about them just throwing folks to the wolves. Here's some rations and a fancy suit. Good luck. Well, don't you worry that smooth little face of yours. You are in good company now. Because around here, we look after one another. Now, what can I do for you? Some other time then.
Duchess is damn lucky you showed up when you did. Hope she comped you a drink or two.
I hope we can set up more settlements like Foundation. I've got friends out there that didn't want to come with me.
Overseer's log, south of Vault 76. I knew this wasn't going to be the Appalachia I remembered, but... mutated animals? Haywire bots? No people so far. We have to be ready to rebuild in... what I can confirm is... hostile territory. Fortunately, Vault-Tec was prepared. You see this? The cooking station, the stash box, the workbenches, all built with the camp. You need a home base out there. The construction and assembly mobile platform is designed to give you one. Just add resources, planning, and a little elbow grease. When you move your camp, everything you've built is stored, ready to be placed back down in the new area. Use this to establish a foothold whenever you're in unfamiliar territory. I've left my camp behind so you can use it. I know I'm breaking my own advice by not taking it with me. But after seeing Appalachia for myself, I need to make sure every resident of 76 has a safe haven they can start from. I'll make do without it. If it's still standing, the town of Flatwoods is further down this road. Find me there. This is the Overseer. Signing off.
Are you real or imaginary?
this place up is hard work. Harder to see. It might rain later. Keep your eyes peeled in this weather.
Overseer's log, town of Flatwood. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations, we expected. There's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions and...
Make yourself at home.
I did.
Before they were wiped out, the survivors called themselves the Responders. Looks like they were made of firefighters, police, emergency medical staff. They even have an automated system to teach people about treating water, food, survival. I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagine, but someone's got to know where the missile silos are and how to secure them. The Responders are the best lead we have. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Stories for posterity, you know. Seems like a fine idea. So, hi, I am Kesha McDermott. When the bombs fell, I was in Watoga, coordinating a statewide science fair for that year's high school kids. And the theme was the future of energy. After the bombs, everything was pretty chaotic. Scavenging for food and fighting off rabid survivors. Oh, it was just a bad time all around. I found a couple of surviving kids from the high school whose parents didn't make it. And we holed up in a house in town for a while. After a bit, I was able to solder the circuitry in an old radio, and we tuned in to a broadcast from the Responders. Oh, we were overjoyed. The trip from Watoga to Flatwoods, it was rough, mind you. The kids and I ran into a group of assholes in the mountains who stole our food and water. I can't tell you how happy I was to find the Responders in Flatwoods. Tents for everyone, open kitchen, medical supplies, protection. We were safe. They had a problem, though. Their water sources were contaminated heavily. People were boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse too. It's going to take time and care, that's all. Well, time, care, and science.
Thank you.
Make yourself at home. I did.
Delbert Winters here, born and raised in this very town. Lent my own church to the responders for their outpost here, and you're welcome. The responders are on a true mission, you see, helping folks through thick and thin, till the heavens open up again and take us all up anyways. When this all happened, I figured like most, it was time. This was the end, but it wasn't. Was it? We're still here. At first, I thought it was a mistake, that we was missed, forgotten. Maybe we did some wrong. Didn't give enough to charity, maybe. Didn't praise his name, even in the worst of times. Maybe thought some things that ought not to have been thought. So I asked him. I asked how. Why? I fought your wars on Earth. I'm ready to fight them up there by your side. Then, in my despair, I saw some survivors eating raw rat carcass behind a dumpster. You ought to cook that first, I warned them. It seemed obvious. We tried but got sick, they said, covered in their own filth. I realized right then and there that I was being tasked. From then on, I built kitchens, cooked good food, fed anyone who walked up with an empty belly, and I was thankful for my task in life. Thankful. Next time hell or high water land in my stoop, I'll be swept clear away with it. But until then, let's share a home-cooked meal together, all right?
Hi there. Chloe's my pet. Or maybe I'm hers. I'm not sure.
Clean up this, fix that. It never seems to end.
got her at a discount since she was decoded. Only thing she puts down these days are piles of sheet metal.
That's hard work making a living out here.
Thorn bushes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Foundation and those raiders of the crater just don't get along. They want to take everything we've worked for.
I'm all out of water.
Together.
scorched or the ferals don't get you, the rats will.
ammunition and other supplies available here. Be sure to stock up while you can. Don't face the wasteland without the proper supply. Welcome, citizen. I am authorized to trade supplies. Authorized to trade supplies and equipment. Trading for supplies, ammunition, and gear. If you have supplies to trade, I can be of service. Thank you.
clawing at the door. I locked myself in a storage closet, but I don't think the door opens from the inside. It's okay. Everything is okay.
Overseer's log. Morgantown. I used to love coming here on weekends, taking flight lessons. Now it feels like I walked into a nightmare. Those scorched things are everywhere. I kept quiet. They didn't see me. I managed to observe them for a bit. Whatever this disease is, it seems to completely take over its host. The ones that used to be human, eventually they go rigid, like some kind of stasis. And if they stay like that for too long, they sort of burn up from the inside out. Vesuvius in reverse. I wondered what could possibly cause this. And then I got my answer. It swooped down from the sky, screeching, breathing, infecting everything. I don't know how to fight this. But we need to consider all our options. Even the nukes. We find the source of this scorched plague and wipe it from the map before it can leave Appalachia. But first things first, we can't let the disease spread to us. Looks like the responders were developing some kind of inoculation. I'm going to pick up their work. You should too. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Wander Survivors Volunteer Program. Advanced Training. Camping. By Miguel Caldera. Robot Programmer Extraordinaire. Part 1. Finding the perfect camping location. Now that the world has changed, it's hard to stay safe. Used to be that camping was safe as houses. Well, until there was a strong wind, right? These days, nothing is really safe. Even in your camp, someone might hurt you. The perfect spot doesn't matter now. It's all about your defenses. You can build near people you trust who will watch your back, or build things that will watch your back for you. No problem. Anyone can do it. Remember, camps are mobile. We're all explorers now, camping in a strange land full of adventure, wonder, and danger. So, camp often, and rest a lot. Before the war, I was gonna retire and go camping. Now I can do it every day, forever. It's a dream come true. Do what you love, right? Now come to my camp, and I can show you some knots and framing techniques. Then, I'll direct you onto some helpful supplies. Good luck, volunteer.
Thank you.